Hi, good morning all. This is a semi-automatic biochemistry analyzer. Model name is Analytica. In this machine, we can perform blood test. We are having a 48 shortcut keys given on the both side. One key is having a dual function. You can see one key is having a two test name written on it. While you press this key single time, you can select the test written on the upper side. If you want to select the lower side test, you have to press it twice. Now we are going to perform the glucose test on this unit. So we have to press this key twice, or we can hold this key more than 1 second also, then it will automatically select the lower test. Like I hold this key for more than 1 second. Now it has selected the glucose test. See the test name. It's showing the various parameters, but before proceeding further for the test, we have to enter the parameters given on the reagent kit literature. Whichever company reagent we are using, we have to enter these parameters as per that literature. So for entering that, we have to go to this edit tab. This is the edit. Now it's showing the option like journal. In journal, we can select the test name and the other parameters as per the literature. First of all, we'll see the literature with available with our reagent kit. See, this is a literature. It's shown the mode is endpoint. Wavelength is given 505. Sample volume, reagent volume, linearity, lag time, everything is given, and the units of the reagent is mgdl. So we have to use the units mgdl also, and concentration is giving 100. So standard value of concentration is 100, so we have to enter that value also. We'll fill the parameters as per this literature. See, now I'm going to I have entered the parameters as per the literature. You can see that in general I have entered glucose, method is no blank, unit is mgdl, respiration volume is 450, sample volume is 10, reagent volume is 1000, and factor we have to calculate because this is a endpoint method, so we have to calculate the factor. Settings, this is an endpoint, wavelength 505 I have entered. This is the lag time that I have entered. Temperature is 37 because we are going to perform this test on 37 degrees Celsius temperature. Method is biochromatic. Limits are given. The lower limit is 70, higher limit is 110. Mean if the value comes between 70 to 110, then it will give the normal value result. Otherwise, it will give the sugar level is low or high as per the result. Linearity is given 0 to 500. And this is our value of concentration. We have entered 100 as it is written on the sample. That the value of 100 concentration also written on the standard. See, you can see on this bottle 100 mgdl is written. The same value we have entered here. Now you can see the 100 value. After entering all these parameters, we have to press the save key. We have saved the values of the parameter. Now we will go to the start. This is a screen. After setting the wavelength, temperature, it will demand for the please aspirate the distilled water. So now we will aspirate the distilled water. Here we have the distilled water. Now I am going to aspirate this. The beep sound tells us that the indication that aspiration has been completed. Now it will test the distilled water. because this is an end point no blank method. So after distributor we have to press the Kali. We will press the Kali. Now it is only aspirated 100 mg DL standard. So we have to mix the standard with the reagent for calculating the factor, and same procedure, reagent with the blood serum sample, we'll mix that and incubate that for the 10 minutes. As per this literature, it is written in this that we have to incubate that for 10 minutes, then we can perform the test. Now we will mix the standard and the reagent, and standard and sample also. Standard with reagent and sample with reagent. This is our glucose reagent. Now I'm going to use this glucose reagent 1000 microliter with this micropipette, set it on 1000 because we need a quantity of 1000 microliter as per the literature. This is a 1000 microliter reagent. Now I'm going to mix the standard of 10 microliter in this reagent. This is a standard and I'm going to mix 10 microliter standard with this micropipette. Now I have mixed the standard in this test tube. Reagent and standard are in there. So we will incubate this solution for 10 minutes at 37 degrees Celsius as per the literature. This is another mixture of reagent and blood serum sample. We will also incubate this for the 10 minutes. Then we will aspirate it for calculating the results. As the incubation time has been completed, see it's showing bit pinkish color. Now we are going to aspirate this standard. See. Machine is calculating the value of the standard and now it will show the factor. It is showing 290 is the factor. We can save this factor by pressing enter. Factor has been saved. Now we can aspirate the sample. See, it is showing the result 95, means the sugar level of this sample is 95, which is in a normal limit. We have one another sample, we can aspirate that also and check the value. Because once we have open any window and calculate the factor, we can aspirate samples one after another. In a sequence, we will get the results continuously and see it is showing the concentration 100, means the sugar level of this sample is 100, because we are having a two different normal samples, so both are giving the two different results. This is how we can perform the glucose test. We can print this graph also on this thermal paper. So for printing this graph, we have to press this curve key. You can see this curve. We have to press this key. See, it is showing the curve. The graphical representation of the recently performed glucose test. So this curve is for the second sample whose concentration is 100. So By this method, we can perform the test. Thank you.